situated away from the rest of the raid at all times, and they just
they're like on the opposite side of the raid.
Exactly. And they're trying to just maximize distance as much as they can.
So the ring, they're like over here.
So they're still in the middle of the room because if you have RNG of having the smaller ring as your last ring.
I just think when it's like that, where it's like if you're it's center ring or one of like the smaller rings, that's when you would have to just basically eat it and say like I need to just step out and die.
Just a lot of responsibility for everyone in the raid to be willing to sacrifice and be ready to use cooldowns that you have to use. A little bit further.
It's 1 DPS that gets chunked at the beginning of the fight. It's great. Scary man. Okay, here comes Surging Darkness. Get ready, guys. Middle. Inside. Middle.
Oh, what a rookie.
See, this is a terrible.
I had to run up with the... Okay, check your range 5, guys.
Pull him back there, please.
Collapse,
so,
guys.
Yep,
try to get up there.
Going over to there.
I got one circle, guys.
Kind of staying right there.
Good job.
And sweeping. That's looking a lot better on the Warriors right now, guys.
Good job, guys. Interrupts on Void Weaver. Ready for more laser beams, guys? They're coming right after the Warriors here. Surging Darkness is also gonna come in here, so spread out.
Yeah, we need to re-CC one of those Void Weavers.
In middle. Stay spread out. Middle.
They're all dead.
Slow.
So, out of curiosity, who's not saving their cooldowns from the one Warriors pop? Because you should be.
Your DPS on Zekfoss is really insignificant. It doesn't matter for the beginning.
Yeah, we're getting him down decent HP, like 20% every time, by doing very little to him, except for just like getting him in there. Like, not putting a lot into him.
Man, there's gotta be a way to keep the guy alive. I mean, is there. What's the.
We gotta kill the most scattered warrior.
I'm trying to think, is there,
turn and cleave.
Try to save the people that, can, that have to be forced to go into search.
If someone calls it, say like, I have to eat this one, or I'm about to step out, can I get a cooldown? If they call it, then we'll use it, because we don't know.
Yeah, say Milk CD or Acid.
Right, I think that's what we might need to do, like Cocoon, or like throw out a, whatever the Dispriests have, Pain Suppression. Or...
Iron Heart's up once a minute.
Nice, okay. I think that's what we might need to do, because I noticed that Dabasaur did absolutely nothing. So... trying to think here. Yeah, it did 100k damage, so if I can just somehow suppress that.
Or are we gonna Iron Bark it? Maybe Iron Bark would be better. Well, I mean, we don't really need
it. And sub stack.
Yeah, we don't really need it as a tank.
All healing cooldown stack.
Boiling Deceit the 43.8k damage every second as well. And how long are we? I noticed it was ticking pretty big on me.
It's a long time.
It's about, I know it's about 30k damage. 30 to 34k damage.
It's 43.8 every 3 seconds.
Yeah, 43.8, yeah, that's right.
That's not too bad.
I think it's like 50 or 60% of your health the whole time you have
it. It's pretty brutal. So the there's three ticks of that, so that needs to be healed, and then,
so here, let's try to watch for who has the rolling deceit, and then, whenever, so if you guys don't have to eat it, you don't have to say anything, but if you do have to eat the Surging Darkness, tell, just say your name and say CD, and that will allow us to make sure we get a pop CD on you, or, like, the healers need to also know which, who's casting what on who, so you guys don't overlap. So, who has a personal focused CD that you guys can use as healer? So Cindy can be like, Cindy can get the first person who says anything, she can do something. Or Umbo can get the pain suppression on the first person who says something.
Do you think we should advance this now?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is going to be our progression boss for the week.
Yeah, it is. It should be.
Any thought, I know that this may not be the strat that we've watched in the video. Is there any thought to maybe heroing on that first ad set? I know the second stage, there's a lot of damage going on and whatnot, but if we're getting him down, if we're killing 20%, you know, which is just what we're doing.
Unfortunately, it's too intense of a burn during the mind control phase, because if we don't, then we
start losing players.
Yeah,
because if we don't kill it before, like, two or three of the mind controls pop, we're pretty much dead.
Y'all can donate any money to me. I have a few Vantus runes, but if y'all can donate any money to me, then...
What do we need for Vantus runes? What's the...
But yeah, like Churn said, please save all of your big-ass cooldowns for the warriors. And, I mean, you guys did such a better job of stacking up on that circle. That's exactly
great.
What we
That's
do.
All I have as far as Vantus runes go right now. Hold on one second. I'm going to put mine up, and I'm going to try to create some...
What are the mats for Vantus runes?
So I have... Let's see. Vantus runes. I just need more Crimson Ink right now. That's all I need.
Did you look in the G-Bank? I think there's some...
No, I haven't looked yet, but I think I might have already used...
What's that, like, a prox off of herbs?
Yeah.
So you need... Can you get the frost ones? Is that okay?
Yeah, if you have frost ones, I can mill those, and I can use that. I don't see any crimson ink.
I have, like, thousands on my old switch.
Thousands.
Baller.
There's 73 crimson ink under the raid stock tab. There you
go. Okay.
I got it. Here. Okay.
I can make six more now.
This is a beanie. I have enough for our. I made three of them, so if you need one, open.
These monks are popular. They're busy as shit.
Monks and usually me.
Yeah, that's right. A resident party.
Two more. Who else needs one? If you don't have a Vantus rune, please feel free to trade me now. Alright. So the target Zeklos and use that. That'll at least help a little bit with the first.
Well, it does damage too.
Increases your. your damage and increases your survival. Reduce damage taken.
So now we just use all our cooldowns on the warriors and
alright, let's do it, guys. Honestly, we're not in a bad place. I think once we clean up these pools, we'll really start making some progress because it's just about executing. It's a little bit cleaner.
Hey, DPS did randomly get chunked to like 20% this time. Congrats.
That's good.
We waited. We're learning.
Learning, dude. Learning.
Here comes Surging Darkness in 5 seconds.
Yeah. That at the last second.
That was the second one.
I did taunt him, but he just went back to you.
Yep.
Outside. Middle.
Ouch.
No.
Outside. Good job, guys. Spread out. Spread out.
Oh, somebody pulled one.
So wipe it. Wipe it. Or not.
Hold on right now.
You only got 3 dead.
I want us to get some attempts in where we can make progress. That would
be more.
Okay, stack up, guys.
When I want everybody to pop CDs when this Yogg is about to die. I want everybody to use CDs per. Working on these warriors, get them down, keep hitting the void reaper, please. You've got the boss right now, and I'm gonna take him.
Someone needs a re-CC diamond.
I still have too many warriors up right now.
We need to be a little careful where we're laying down the void lash, because some of the melee, like, I got hit by that when I'm meleeing the new Ruby Weaver.
Yeah, we're gonna try to pull the boss a little bit further so it's not. We had an issue at the beginning because of aggro on boss right now is an absolute bitch because
tanks.
They made it that way, so yeah, enjoy it.
They enjoy suffering.
Yeah. Aggro is a lot more fickle than it used to be. That's why I apologize. But yeah, we're gonna try to pull the boss a little bit further past the ad. So basically, the boss is going to be on top of the other adds, but so Thanos, whenever I take the boss, like I'm going to try it, whenever I have the boss, I'm going to pull him past that a little bit, but during that time, I think that you should have him normally. So just a little bit further, and we'll be okay.
What, like on the first pull?
No. I mean, whenever all the adds pop up, you usually have the boss, right? Because I'm pretty sure we transition right before he does that.
Yeah.
Because we come out of Surging Darkness and it's on me. Either way, I'll just make sure. Like, if I have the boss, we'll make sure that we just drop it a little bit further past the adds. That way, whenever this code.
You're cutting out, Bill.
Sorry.
So we're waiting for the shaman win first, and then I can chain them together after. Is that what?
No, all I mean to say is that we just need to make sure that the cone that Zekvoss is dropping in front of him is not going to hit the raid. We need to pull the boss further.
But like, say if the boss, so like, say right here, so the ad is going to spawn on the marker, right?
Yeah.
So he's just saying pull the boss further in front of the. So basically, the ad will be on Zekvoss's ass.
Correct.
Technically. So that way, when Zek does his ability, he's not cleaving down melee.
Yeah, I think maybe we need to move the boss a little bit further, maybe to like right there or something like that. That way, that works a little better. Shouldn't be a big deal.
Okay.
Don't fall asleep, CK. We need you. Y'all get so bored with progression, but this is what y'all come to this for. This is what y'all.
This is fun. It's just a little overwhelming.
Oh, it is. Absolutely.
I haven't raided Mythic since like 2 weeks before the crunch,
yeah.
The item level crunch in Legion.
Yeah.
I'm a little rusty.
All good.
A little rusty.
We We just gotta iron out the mechanics a little bit and we'll get there. It's very hectic.
I just got a little flustered during the ring.
Side. Middle. CD on silver. Inside. Okay, spread out. I-beam's going out. Spread out, guys.
I'm gonna take one big team.
Spread out. Stay spread out.
Abs incoming in 3 seconds.
Get ready to collapse on square. Collapse on square.
Pull the boss further back. Pull the boss further back. There we go. Looking good. That's perfect. We're looking really good. We got one ad straggling, but just try to keep focus on cleaving these guys down and interrupting the void weaver still. Still try to get that void weaver on top.
Up. Ready to spread for lasers.
Alright, all the warriors look like they're down, so I'm moving over to the
rolling the seat
diamond.
Also coming in, spread out guys, rolling the seat coming in.
Surging darkness is going out, so we're gonna do that and kill this guy.
The other one's broken.
Back. That ad over there needs to be CC'd, guys.
You guys have to pay attention to your CDs. Or your CCs, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Well, also we need to be careful.
I just refreshed it right before.
We were supposed to wait for after that that fucking circle shit and then go to triangle.
I mean, we shouldn't. I don't know if we need to wait that long though. I don't know if that's.
Well, with Surging Darkness, we can't break a CD. We have to wait till Surging Darkness is over. Before
right,
actually DPSing one of the bigger ads, we just have to keep them CC'd until it's done.
Okay, it just feels like a lot of downtime for us to do absolutely.
Well, you're not. You can do damage to the boss. I think Cindy's right though.
Okay.
That was a lot better, by the way. Everyone was saving their CDs for warriors and shit. They actually died.
Silver, did you cloak that?
Silver survived that. How did
I gave him Guardian Spirit, but I'm wondering if he cloaked it, because I think he can cloak it.
Yeah, you can cloak Surging Darkness and drop him low in the sea.
Awesome. So, I mean, you can survive it, it seems like.
Because I'm saying, like, I use my Guardian Spirit on Silver, because if he can cloak it and use that, because he can, that's an immunity, period. I could use cloak. I could have used my Guardian Spirit on CK.
Okay. So,
if I Ice Block, I won't be able to move. I'm going to see.
Right. Well, if you use Ice Block, let me know because I can rip you back in.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Surging Darkness is 150k.
You can feel free to Ice Block facing the raid and then just like blink afterwards after it.
Yeah. And I mean, it's only a split, like, you'll only have a second to grip me out because otherwise I'll just end up popping more than. My own run.
Oh, we need a feast.
Yeah, so it looks like Surging Darkness definitely can't be mitigated.
Okay, so then our new game plan is going to be to kill that first marker, kill Blue and the Warriors before the Surging Darkness. We'll not touch the diamond or the triangle. And then we'll kill the triangle after that Surging Darkness. Okay? So I need you guys to try to be very careful with your AoEs and anything you have there, and do not touch the triangle or the diamond until after the Surging Darkness goes out for that.
So we shouldn't even transition the boss to after it. We shouldn't even move it to the triangle.
Right. I'm not going to. I'm not going to.
next big challenge is to, like, deal with the laser beams in Surging Darkness.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, that's our next one.
Hey, Fort.
Darkness coming. 5 seconds, rolling his teeth going out. Surging Darkness coming. Middle. Inside. Middle. Inside. I-beams going out. Spread out, guys. Collapse on circle, watch CCs.
Azure needs CCs.
Pull the boss a little bit further, please. Thank you.
Diamond needs to be CC'd, please.
Got it. Watch, make sure you're not hitting any of the CC guys. So everybody's focused you. We're not gonna touch the other ads, we're just down and happen here, okay? Surgeon's about to go out, I got the boss.
Good job, guys. Spread out for laser. Spread out for laser,
ready.
Don't touch the ads. Shit.
Try not to disturb the CC.
Milk's gonna need a CD here.
The void reap is up. Someone needs to ice block mine or
something. Yeah, re-CC, man.
Oh.
Yeah, re-CC.
It wasn't even, I mean, we broke that CC too many times as a part of it, too.
And I think it's, there's a diminishing return on it, so you can't stun it.
Like, my problem with waiting on that is when we died there, we had ads come 30 second. So we're gonna get stacked. We're gonna end up with, we're not killing them fast enough. We're just not doing DPS right now, honestly. Like, I don't know if we need to change talents to do more AoE with a single target or something like that, but right now we're not doing enough DPS to the ads to transition quickly enough to clear them out before the next ads phase will begin.
Yeah, so we should be faster on the ads. That strat's not gonna work, huh?
Yeah, I think that we, like, and when you're looking at the video and everything like that, they keep the boss and they just get on to the next one and in darkness they go, but I don't think that we can afford to wait that long to go to the next ad, unfortunately, because we just are gonna end up getting more. So I think that we're cleaning it up. I think we're killing the ads a lot quicker. I think we're doing a better job. I just don't think we can afford to stop DPS on.
From what I noticed, the range of finishing off the warriors as the man that went on to the second.
What was that, I'm sorry?
During the video, as they go on to the second ad, melee is hitting the second ad and range is finishing off the warriors.
Right, exactly.
That's how quick it is.
So then we get the third ad then after the Surging Darkness, leave the third ad CC?
Yes, exactly. So yeah, that's going to be kind of our goal. It's kind of what our original game